Hello and welcome to Bobcat Update. I'm Christina Ochoa. Today we have stories about ongoing construction and expansion projects in San Marcos.
And what you could do to prepare yourself to find a job. I'm Eric Pompa. Bobcat Pride is on full display at Texas State Homecoming. Celebrates homecoming. The events this week include students painting windows at the LBJ Student Center and participating in the homecoming talent show at Evans Auditorium. Also, singer Andy Grammer will perform at the Homecoming Spirit Rally Thursday night at Sewell Park. The spirit-raising events are all in support of the football team, which hosts Idaho on Saturday. At the game, the homecoming queen and king will be crowned. Finding a job is a challenge, even in the best of times. It may be necessary for students to find ways to show potential employers that they stand above the rest. In this Bobcat update, Jenny Sessions offers some tips on how to handle the job search.
It's hard to find work in a competitive job market. While some students have found ways to make lemonade out of life's lemons by straying away from the corporate world, others are hoping to put their degrees to use. Students are now being advised to take extra precautions when applying for jobs.
It's very, very important. I mean, the earlier the better. When I graduated personally, I had 3 internships under my belt, which made me very competitive to the other students that were applying for the same position. If you come out with a great GPA, that's awesome. But if you get a GPA plus work experience under your belt, even better.
Companies are looking for interns younger and younger now, so they are actually looking for them to start at sophomore level.
The university has several resources for students. They can find help in career counseling, job postings, and networking. The idea is to help prepare students for the job market and offer guidance in launching their careers.
I have probably the normal worries like everybody else, but I'm confident in my skills and stuff like that, and hopefully there's some people in here that see some of that.
Many students are utilizing the services offered by the university, such as a career center and job fairs. With the job market being so competitive, it could pay to start early. For Bobcat Update, I'm Jenny Sessions.
The U.S. Supreme Court hears arguments today on whether racial preferences should be used in college admissions. The case was brought by a white woman who claims the University of Texas chose not to admit her because of her race. Abigail Fisher claims such a move violates the Constitution's equal protection guarantee. But the university says that using race as a factor in admissions helps keep the student body diverse and ensures minority representation on campus. 9 years ago, the Supreme Court ruled to approve such policies. However, since then, the court has become increasingly conservative.
The U.S. Anti-Doping Agency has released a report today involving Lance Armstrong. The report accuses Armstrong of using performance-enhancing drugs to help him win races. More than 1,000 pages of evidence have been put together against Armstrong. The report accuses the 7-time Tour de France champion of cheating. 11 of Armstrong's former teammates have come forward providing information supporting the allegations.
Kentucky Center College is preparing for Thursday's one and only vice presidential debate. That means making sure alumnus Fred Vinson doesn't miss it. Students have moved the portrait of Vinson, known to the college as Dead Fred, to the debate hall. So, who is Fred Vinson? He served as the U.S. Supreme Court Chief Justice 60 years ago. The college says Vinson's portrait is always present at home football games, so it needs to be on hand for Thursday's showdown between Vice President Joe Biden and Congressman Paul Ryan. Go, Fred.
After the first presidential debate, recent poll numbers show that challenger Mitt Romney is ahead of President Barack Obama. According to a CNN poll of polls, Romney has a support of 48% of likely voters, with Obama at 47%. With this week's vice presidential debate and 2 more showdowns between Obama and Romney still to come, the polls can quickly shift again.
Beer drinkers of America rejoice. Out of 150 countries studied, it takes the least amount of time to earn a beer in the United States. That's according to analysis at the Swiss Bank. The analysis looked at median hourly wages and average beer prices at grocery and retail stores. They didn't consider bar prices. They determined it takes Americans just 5 minutes on the job to earn a beer. But outside the U.S., the typical worker has to work at least 20 minutes for their first brew.
After the break, learn how you can save time by shopping for supplies on campus.
And find out why Toyota is recalling more than 7 million vehicles worldwide.
Oh, I don't feel good. I'm gonna call the health center.
This is Manuel, appointment clerk. How can I help you?
Hi, I'm really not feeling good and I really need to see somebody today.
The Student Health Center offers quality care in their state-of-the-art facility, conveniently located on a campus across from the LBJ Student Center. They offer same-day appointments with an easy self-check-in desk in the receptionist lobby. The health center is equipped with an experienced healthcare staff, including licensed physicians and nurse practitioners. It offers primary care, women's health, and psychiatric services. There's an on-site laboratory, digital x-ray machine, and a full-service pharmacy. It's your one-stop shop for healthcare with convenient pay options for college students. To make an appointment, call 512-245-2161. Or to learn more about the Student Health Center, go to www.healthcenter.txstate.edu.
The patience of San Marcos motorists is being tested because of ongoing construction just north of campus. The $2.6 million project has resulted in lanes on North LBJ and Chestnut being closed to through traffic. The city is installing two new underground water pipes to increase system capacity and overall reliability. Also, North LBJ from Sesame to Holland will be widened with the addition of sidewalks and bike lanes. City officials say the project should be finished in a couple of months.
The HEB store at Hopkins and Thorpe is undergoing an $11 million expansion. When the project is finished, the store will have a greater focus on nutrition. A larger variety of produce will be available along with a bigger bakery and deli department. Meanwhile, HEB is adjusting to the construction inside of the store by temporarily changing the store layout and combining certain products to one aisle. The expansion, which should be finished in December, will add 30 to 40 new jobs. Well, for many Texas State students, finding supplies for campus for classes can be quite difficult. In this Bobcat update, Evan Bolton takes a look at how students are getting the office supplies they need.
Notebooks, pencils, staples, folders, and many other items needed for classes can be found at the university bookstore. Many students believe these items to be overpriced, when in fact the costs are very comparable to what can be found at other office supply stores.
Well, the prices are going to be similar. We carry probably the same type of merchandise.
Many students find the same supplies on campus that they would find at other stores.
Yeah, I see students come in daily buying a lot of office supplies, such as spirals, binders, note cards, pencils, and pens. Anything last minute, that's normally what they'll come here to buy.
Though the university bookstore sells a variety of products, from Texas State apparel to electronics, many students still buy school supplies every day.
I come here to get shirts, pens, binders, and spirals.
Whether students need spiral notebooks, binders, or any other typical office supplies, the university bookstore is a convenient alternative. For Bobcat Update, I'm Evan Bolton.
Residents in Central Texas have seen gas prices go down lately. The price for gas has fallen about 7 cents a gallon in the past week, compared to the national average, which has increased 6 cents a gallon. This puts the average gasoline price in the area at $3.53.
The U.S. government is suing Wells Fargo over allegation of mortgage fraud. The lawsuit accuses the bank of making reckless and fraudulent home mortgage loans for a decade, costing the government $190 million. According to the complaint, the Federal Housing Administration had to pay insurance claims on defaulted loans that were falsely certified by Wells Fargo. Wells Fargo released a statement yesterday denying the allegations. Similar lawsuits have been filed against four other banks. Three of them have been settled.
Travelers are apparently losing confidence in American Airlines. American has had its share of bad publicity lately, with the safety issues and on-time delivery being top concerns. The airline has been coping with flight delays and cancellations in the wake of pilot anger over their contracts. CNN reports that American has been forced to cut many of its domestic flights, and the airline is losing customers. In September alone, the number of passengers flying American Airlines was down 4%. Business travelers in particular are abandoning American in favor of more reliable transportation.
Toyota is recalling about 7.5 million vehicles worldwide due to a faulty power window switch. The power switch on the driver's side didn't have grease applied evenly throughout production, causing friction in the switch and sometimes smoke. More than a dozen Toyota models made from 2005 to 2010 are being recalled. No crashes or injuries have been reported relating to the problem.
When we come back, we'll tell you about a 5K run to benefit charity.
And some people are buying books to help the library.
The San Marcos Greenbelt Alliance is working to connect all of the natural areas surrounding San Marcos so everyone will be able to experience the serenity and beauty of nature. Imagine having the opportunity to hop on a mountain bike and ride through trails without the hustle and bustle of traffic. But the San Marcos Greenbelt Alliance's vision cannot be possible without dedicated volunteers. Volunteers do a number of things, including clearing paths and building trails. Once these paths are cleared, anyone can use them to enjoy the outdoors or to get to a variety of different locations. For more information on how to get involved with the San Marcos Greenbelt Alliance, visit their website at smgreenbelt.org or call 512-754-9321.
The Alpha Delta Pi sorority at Texas State is sponsoring a 5K run to benefit the Ronald McDonald House. The fourth annual Ronald McDonald Run will be held on October 20th, along with a one-mile Pups Fun Run. AD Pi encourages students to participate. Those who run in the 5K will be separated by age and gender, but the Pups Fun Run will include everyone. The cost is $15 for each race or $25 for both. The top three contestants in each category will receive prizes. All benefits will be donated to charity.
The Friends of San Marcos Public Library is hosting a fall book sale. Get the best deals on gently used books. The sale will take place on October 12th through the 14th at the San Marcos City Park. Sale hours are from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. on Friday and 10 p.m. to 5 p.m. on Saturday and Sunday. Proceeds from the sale benefit the San Marcos Public Library.
At a drive-up window, you hope for speed and accuracy. Friendliness counts too. Well, a fast food industry magazine just released a study on how well the chains are doing, and the winner depends on what you're looking for. Chick-fil-A led the way in terms of getting orders right and for customer service and cleanliness. Wendy's was the fastest, and ranking number two for speed was Taco Bell. At the opposite end of the scale was Burger King. The magazine QSR said Burger King fairly poorly in both accuracy and speed. The study was conducted this past summer at locations in 41 states.
Chicago and San Antonio are in a race to lose weight. The two cities are participating in a new wellness challenge, and the winner gets a $5 million prize, courtesy of Soda Pop Industry. The soda makers have pledged to offer more low-calorie drinks in their machines and to display calorie information more prominently. The cities are hoping the effort will encourage their employees to make healthier choices.
A Florida man has died after he collapsed from eating dozens of roaches and worms. Edward Archbold was among 20 to 30 contestants participating in a contest to win an $850 python. The goal of the contest was to try and eat as many insects and worms. According to the Brown Ward County Sheriff's Office, once the contest was over, Archbold fell ill and began to vomit. He dialed 911 before collapsing. An ambulance took him to North Brown Ward Medical Center, where he was pronounced dead. Autopsy results are still pending.
Here's at least one indicator that the American economy is recovering. Pet costumes are making a comeback. That's right. American pet owners love to dress up their furry friends to spook their neighbors. The National Retail Federation says about $370 million will be spent on Halloween costumes for pets. That's a whopping 40% more than pet owners spent just 2 years ago.
Are you going to dress up your pet for Halloween?
I do. I have a dog. I think I have a costume in mind, so aww, hopefully it goes well. How about you?
No, I don't. Sadly, I don't have a pet, but I kind of want a cat, so maybe I'll get one.
There you go.
Well, that's all for this edition of Bobcat Update. Join us tomorrow at 4:30.
Have a great weekend.